Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to wrap text around a circle in Microsoft Word. First, we'll insert a circle using Word's Shape tool. However, you can use an image of a circular object if you wish. Then, we'll use WordArt to wrap text around the circle. Lastly, we'll group the text and circle together so they can be moved as one object. Don't miss the important tip at the end of that section for those having trouble with the grouping process. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to Word for Mac and the recent single purchase versions of the software. If you've already inserted an image of a circular object, please feel free to skip to the next section. To insert a circle shape, begin by selecting the Insert tab. Then select Shapes in the Illustrations group. From there, select the oval shape. And then press and hold the Shift key as you drag the shape onto the page. Holding the Shift key lets you create a perfect circle rather than an oval. If you'd like to change the appearance of your circle, please see my previous shape tutorial, which will be linked below. Now we're going to use WordArt to wrap text around the circle. To begin, select the Insert tab. Then select the WordArt button. Next, choose one of the default designs from the drop-down menu. Note that these designs can be heavily modified, as shown in my previous WordArt tutorial linked below. After making your choice, a text box will appear saying "Your text here." Type your own text to replace this filler text. Now, select the Shape Format tab if you haven't moved there automatically. This tab only appears when a shape or WordArt is selected. From there, select the Text Effects menu arrow, followed by Transform, and then Circle in the Follow Path section of the submenu. Next, use the text box resizing handles and rotation handle to position the text around the circle. You can also hover your pointer over the WordArt text box border until it becomes two double-headed crossed arrows. Then drag the text box in any direction. In addition, you can select the Rotate button and then choose a rotation or flipping option from the drop-down menu. Mac users can find the Rotation button in the Arrange drop-down menu. Continue to adjust the text until it appears in the desired position around the circle. Now we're going to group the text and shape together so they can be moved throughout the document as one object. These steps also work if you used an image rather than a shape. While selecting both the shape and the text directly on the page is possible, this process can be quite difficult. So today we're going to use the Selection pane instead. To begin, select the Layout tab. Then select the Selection pane button. Next, select the WordArt text box in the Selection pane. And then press and hold the Control key on a PC or Command key on a Mac as you select the shape or image on the Selection pane. Now, select the Group button, followed by Group from the drop-down menu. Your text and circle should be grouped together, and you can move them throughout the document as you would a single object. If you need to ungroup the text and shape later on, select the grouped object, select the Group button, and then select Ungroup from the drop-down menu. Before we close, if you have trouble grouping the objects, select each one separately in the Selection pane, select the Wrap Text menu, and then ensure that neither is set to Inline with Text and that both are set as Move with Text. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below along with my playlists, How to Use Microsoft Word, and How to Use Word for Mac. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.